Tootsie Woodley, Blondie's neighbor, has dropped in for a little chat, and she's telling Blondie about a movie she saw last night. She's saying,
"Oh, Blondie, you must go to the movies tonight. It's simply wonderful. It's so romantic. Why, honestly, Herbert is so sweet and affectionate since we saw it."
And Blondie says,
"Really?"
Last picture, top row, Tootsie goes on rapturously,
"When he picked her up in his strong arms and carried her over the threshold, I nearly swooned."
And Blondie replies,
"How thrilling."
And then Tootsie goes home. Blondie thinks that maybe Dagwood might become nice and romantic to her if he saw such a romantic picture. So first picture, next row, she says to him sweetly,
"Dagwood, darling, would you like to go to the movies tonight?"
And Dagwood, who has settled down in a sweet chair for a long, comfortable evening at home, exclaims not so sweetly, "No." So they go to the movies. They're sitting in the theater watching a dashing hero making love to a beautiful girl on an island in the South Seas. And Blondie sighs with happiness.
"Oh, my."
And Dagwood sighs with disgust. "Ah." And then Dagwood falls asleep. First picture, next row, Blondie shakes Dagwood, saying,
"Dagwood, stop dozing. Here comes the big love scene."
So Dagwood wakes up just long enough to see that the hero is being pursued by South Sea natives. The hero has carried the beautiful girl to safety with a knife between his teeth as everybody sighs with relief. And from Dagwood we hear, and that's the end of the picture.
Dagwood, wake up. Come on, dear. Get up.
Last picture of the row, Blondie has managed to get Dagwood on his feet and has gotten his hat and coat on and leading him home. And she says,
"Dagwood, wake up. The show is over and we're on our way home."
But Dagwood doesn't know what happens. He's so drowsy. And by the time you can go, Blondie and Dagwood are home. Dagwood leans against the front of the house as Blondie says,
"Wasn't that romantic when he carried her over the threshold?"
But Dagwood just answers, and then slowly slides down to the ground. And there he lies on the porch, asleep. Blondie looks at him with disappointment that he isn't carrying her over the threshold like the hero in the movie did. And she gives a sigh.
"Oh, well."
Then takes him by the shoulders and drags him into the house, saying,
"We've been married a long time." That Dagwood, that was no way to act after seeing a romantic picture like that.
Well, what would you like him to do? Put a knife between his teeth and pick Blondie up in his arms and carry her all the way home?
Well, no, not all the way home, but he could at least carry her over the threshold.
With a knife in his teeth?
No, the key.
Oh, excuse me.
That's all right.